It's been rough and rocky traveling, but I'm finally standing upright on the ground. After taking several readings, I'm surprised to find my mind still fairly sound. I guess Nashville was the roughest, but I know I've said the same about them all. We received our education in the cities of the nation, me and Paul. Almost busted in Laredo, but for reasons that I'd rather not disclose. But if you're staying in a motel there and leave, just don't leave nothing in your clothes. And at the airport in Milwaukee, they refused to let us board the plane at all. They said we looked suspicious, but I believe they like to pick on me and Paul. Well, it's been rough and rocky traveling, but I'm finally standing upright on the ground. And after taking several readings, I'm surprised to find my mind still fairly sound. Guess Nashville was the roughest, but I know I've said the same about them all. We received our education in the cities of the nation, me and Paul.
For decades on end, Mount Rainier Scenic Railroad has entertained tourists traveling to Washington State, offering sights of Mount Rainier and the natural beauty of the Cascade Mountains from the comfort of vintage passenger cars, pulled by classic steam and diesel locomotives. Founded in 1980, the railroad operates on a branch line constructed by the Milwaukee Road, with the current operating limits being between Elbe and Mineral. On the morning of the very first day back in operation, the train picks up a baggage car at the Elbe siding, before running the engine around to build the consist. The 70 slowly inches in reverse to make the hook. After a seemingly permanent closure due to financial losses caused by the previous owner's mismanagement coupled with pandemic-related troubles, the Mount Rainier Scenic was acquired by a new operator in 2022, with plans to restore train operations by 2025. In what seems to be nothing short of a miracle, a train schedule for the fall season was announced early in 2023, with plans to operate every weekend from September towards the end of October. The Poulsen 70 was returned to operating condition by the group running the railroad, and is the sole operating steam engine at the present time. The Poulsen 70, a Mikado-class steam locomotive made to pull log trains, was built in 1922 by Baldwin Locomotive Works for Poulsen Logging Company in Hoquiam, Washington, making her 101 years old this year. Now, with the train consist ready, passengers, train crew, and railfans are all filled with anticipation, awaiting the very first departure from Elbe. We find ourselves at the western grade crossing on Highway 706 as the train begins boarding passengers. A shrill locomotive whistle echoes through Elbe for the first time in years as the train departs the depot an hour behind schedule. The engineer opens up the throttle on the Poulsen 70 and picks up some speed as the very first train rolls out of town. The train glides around the corner and approaches the eastern 706 grade crossing, and will be going as far as Mineral before turning around.
Thank you.
Now returning from Mineral, just over an hour later, the 70 drags the train across both Nisqually River bridges in reverse. Mount Rainier Scenic's first round trip comes to a conclusion as the train crosses Highway 7 and pulls into Elbe. Off to the right is a unique signal dating back to the Milwaukee Road era, equipped with amber flashing lights and an illuminated no right turn sign, warning motorists using the three-way intersection of oncoming trains.
Packet show in Buffalo with us and Kitty Wells and Charlie Fry. The show's long and we're just sitting there, and we'd come to play and not just for the ride. Well, we drank a lot of whiskey, so I don't know if we went on that night at all. But I don't think they even missed us. I guess Buffalo ain't geared for me and Paul. Well, it's been rough and rocky traveling, but I'm finally standing upright on the ground. After taking several readings, I'm surprised to find my mind still fairly sound. I guess Nashville was the roughest, but I know I've said the same about them all. We received our education in the cities of the nation, me and Paul.
the blistering late summer heat, the 70 approaches Highway 7 with a trainload of tourists bound for mineral. The Nisqually River is a product of glacial runoff originating at the base of Mount Rainier and provides a natural opening for train travelers to see the mountain up close as they ride across.
Trees lining the winding road. I've got a name. I've got a name. Like the singing bird and the croaking toad. I've got a name. I've got a name. And I carry it with me like my daddy did. But I'm living the dream that he kept here. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by. Like a north wind whistling down the sky, I've got a song, I've got a song. Like the whippoorwill and the beaver's cry, I've got a song, I've got a song. And I carry it with me and I sing it loud. If it gets me nowhere, I go there proud. Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by.
The train makes the final return trip of the day as it approaches Highway 706, and we'll follow it back to Elbe as the day grows old.
Thank you.
We find ourselves deep into the wilderness as Poulsen 70 deadheads to Mineral at the end of the day, leaving the rest of the train behind at Elbe. The sun begins to set as the distant cry of the steam whistle can be heard from miles away in this otherwise quiet place, with the only other sound being the wind whispering through the trees and the constant flow of the Nisqually River.
Pass me by.